है गाइस, वेलकम टू मैक मिश्रा चैनल। टुडेज़ टॉपिक इज़ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग। इट्स गोइंग टू बी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टू फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू। सो इट्स अ फिफ्थ लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ द कोरोजन, एंड हियर वी विल डिस्कस एंड वी विल लर्न अबाउट स्वीट कोरोजन एंड सॉर कोरोजन। साउंड्स इंटरेस्टिंग? या रियली दीज आर नॉट द टेस्ट आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट, बट रियली दीज आर द स्वीट एंड सॉर कोरोजन। वन इज CO2 बेस एंड अनदर इज H2S बेस। ओके, सो लेट्स ट्राई टू सी इन डिटेल। सो स्टे विथ मी एट द एंड ऑफ द सेशन, यू विल बी लर्निंग लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल विल सी द बेसिक अंडरस्टैंडिंग। सो इन बेसिक अंडरस्टैंडिंग वी हैव हर्ड वेरियस टाइम दैट एसिड गैसेस। So basically, what are the acid gases? So acid gases are the gases which when mix in the water or liquid phase form acidic mixture. So basically, two acid gases are well known. First is carbon dioxide, CO2, and second is H2S. So these are the major two acid gases. So both of these gases contribute to the corrosion by increasing the acidity of the water when dissolved in it. Means when these gases dissolve in the water, they increase the acidity by releasing the H plus ion in the that liquid or medium. So here if you see H2 water plus CO2, it will release H plus ion and it will form CO32 minus. Okay, so and here H2S with water, H plus and HS minus, so it will release hydrogen ion, and when hydrogen ion then the pH of the that solution will increase and the medium this will become the acidic medium. So basically the we are talking about sour and sweet corrosion, and this depends on CO2 and H2S. So let's start one by one. First is sweet corrosion. For sweet corrosion we are also calling it CO2 corrosion, carbon dioxide corrosion. So CO2 corrosion results when CO2 dissolve in water to form H2CO3 carbonic acid. The acid may lower the pH, and sufficient quantity may prone to general corrosion and or pitting corrosion of the carbon steel or some alloy steels. So when CO2 get dissolved in the water, it forms carbonic acid and it's lower the pH. So what will be the mechanism? Like this is my steel, this is my steel, okay, and here medium is water in my pipeline or equipment. So what will happen? This water will form this CO2 will release H plus ion, and it will form iron oxide. Okay, CO2 get dissolved and it form carbonic acid, and then what will happen? There will be a formation of anode and cathode on the metal itself. Okay, so iron will get released by absorbing H plus ion and releasing two electrons, and the top layer will be iron this carbonate. Okay, and H2 gas get released. So it's in dissolved gas CO2. So dissolved CO2, when this CO2 is not in form of liquid, it will be in form the gas. But when in my system the partial pressure of CO2 get increased, this solubility in the liquid get increased and it get more dissolved with increase in the partial pressure of the CO2, and it will lower the pH. So and this is the corrosion product get formed on the surface, and he is calling iron carbonate. So the iron carbonate byproduct is the corrosion byproduct. Basically this is a byproduct of the corrosion, and this we are calling iron carbonate, and sometimes we are just calling is siderite. So is term to be remembered. this iron carbonate we are also calling siderite. Okay, so now what are the critical things in this type of corrosion? First is the liquid water must be present for CO2 corrosion, means there should be a liquid medium for CO2 corrosion to occur. If there will not be any liquid medium, CO2 corrosion will not take place. Okay, so second point is increasing the partial pressure, which I have already told. Increasing the partial pressure of the CO2 result in lower the pH and therefore higher the corrosion rate. So how this will happen? When we increase the partial pressure of the CO2, so what will happen? More CO2 will get dissolved in water or liquid system, and more acid will get formed, and it's lower the pH. And when there will be oxygen present in the system, it will aggravate the corrosion, it will accelerate the corrosion. So oxygen should be limited to 10 ppb to avoid the accelerating corrosion. So oxygen should not be more, it should be less. And this CO2 corrosion will show more effect, more corrosion on high velocity and turbulence zones. So if we my system having CO2, we need to avoid this high velocity and turbulent zones in our system, otherwise this corrosion rate will drastically increase. Okay, so this is the sweet corrosion, which we are calling CO2 corrosion. Now we'll try to see something more in detail. So what we call that this partial pressure versus corrosion rate? So first of all, how to calculate the partial pressure? So partial pressure is mole percent into total pressure, so it means what is pressure in the system. So if we multiply mole percent of CO2 in system into psi, total psi, dividing by 100, we are getting the partial pressure. Like 3% mole percent CO2 is there and total pressure is 150 psi, then my partial pressure of CO2 will be 4.5. Partial pressure, basically in a system there will be separate different gases. So what is individual pressure of CO2 in that is called partial pressure. Okay, so when the partial pressure will increase, the CO2, more CO2 will get dissolved and the corrosion rate will also increase. So here we have plotted the CO2 partial pressure versus corrosion rate. So in you see, as the partial pressure is getting increased in psi, so as partial pressure is 10, then corrosion is around 38-39 mpy. When partial pressure got to 15, the corrosion rate has increased to 425. At 75 partial pressure, corrosion rate gone to 600. Okay, 150 psi partial pressure, the corrosion rate gone to 1200 mpy, very high. Likewise, it will get increased depending on the partial pressure. So as partial pressure get increased, the corrosion rate will get increased drastically. So we need to control this. Okay, now we will see when iron react with the carbonic acid, it will form FeCO3, iron carbonate, and it will get further dissolve in the in water. But if this iron carbonate layer becomes stable, then it can protect the further degradation of the iron and it may avoid the corrosion. Okay, so now we will try to understand in what conditions this will be we can protect the further corrosion. So we need to check in what conditions this FeCO3 layer, which get formed on the surface, will be more protective to avoid further corrosion. So first, there are three types of crystals. First is unsaturated, means, and second is saturated crystals, and third is super saturated crystals. Okay, so saturation of iron carbonate when the saturation is less than 1, saturation is equal to 1 and saturation is greater than 1. So depending on that, the corrosion rate, like unsaturated this iron carbonate having higher corrosion rate of 1 to 10 mm per year. Okay, so this basically occurs at lower pH. See the microstructure. This iron carbonate is not saturated and this is not stable film which get formed. Okay, and here the corrosion rate, these layers will get peeled off and another iron carbonate layer get formed and it further get peeled off, and that's why the corrosion rate will increase and metal will loss. Okay, so here CO2 solution, H plus excess route, Fe exits route, so H plus gets on the surface and Fe2 plus get exit route, so the corrosion will be higher. Okay, here when the FeCO3 is unsaturated, okay, the protective layer is unsaturated. Now when the protective layer gets saturated, okay, or no, partially saturated, then the saturation is become equal to 1 and the corrosion rate get reduced, and here partially protective iron carbonate layer get formed. Here see the, now here see, you can't see the crystals, now you can see the crystals. These are the grains, but grain size is large. Okay, these are the larger grains. Here there are some spaces where further corrosion occur. See, these are the crystals, rhombus type crystals, but there are some gaps where there are still chances of the corrosion. And this corrosion rate is low, okay, incomparatively low. And third situation is supersaturated corrosion. Here what will happen, the saturation of iron carbonate is greater than 1 and corrosion rate has drastically reduced, and the FeCO3 this layer formed becomes protective. So this is the ideal condition, and here you see the grain size are become smaller and it has protected all over the surface and it will avoid further corrosion to the system. So the Fe iron carbonate layer is basically very protective here, and that's why here the corrosion rate is low. Hope you have understood this. Now here these are same tables, and here in the first the pH was lower than 5, less than 5, and here pH is moderate 5 to 6, and in the third condition where the stable protective FeCO3 films get formed, the pH is above 6 and here CO2 level will be less, and Fe3O3 crystals are these crystals are more stable. So these are the environmental conditions that affect the FeCO3 corrosion. So hope you have understood this. This is slightly deeper side. So now we'll move ahead to sore corrosion. Sore corrosion is basically H2S corrosion. So H2S corrosion we are calling sore corrosion. So the deterioration of metal due to contact with H2S hydrogen sulfide and moisture is called sore corrosion. So the hydrogen sulfide, when dissolved in water, is a weak acid. So when it will get dissolved in water, weak acid form, and therefore it's a source of hydrogen ion and is corrosive. So when H2S get dissolved, H plus will get released, and same here system will occur, and here iron sulfide scale will form on the surface, FES scale will form. Okay, so this here also there is a condition, this H2S wet H2S corrosion will occur when there will be a liquid stream and H2S get dissolved based on its partial pressure. Okay, so dissolved H2S will cause this corrosion. So hydrogen permeation increase with increase in H2S partial pressure. Okay, as H2S partial pressure will increase, hydrogen will more permit into the solution due to a concurrent increase in the H2S concentration in the water phase. Okay, and a value of 50 ppm WH2S in the water phase is often stated as a minimum concentration where H2S damage can occur. So if H2S will be higher than 15 ppm, then only this H2S damage will occur. Now you can see here the damage of FES layer, so iron sulfide layer at different pH. So first is at pH 4. Here see this this multiple this layer is not stable, and there are multiple break damages to this layer, and this scale is not a very protective scale, FES scale at this pH. Okay, so here the thickness of that scale is around 12 micrometers. Okay, if we further increase pH to 5, then this layer, FES layer, will get somewhat stabilized, and this FES scale layer get reduced. The thickness will get reduced, means there will be less losses, and somewhat stable film will form, and the thickness will be 5 μm. Now the third scenario is when this pH is 6. This is the somewhat ideal case. Here the thickness much more reduced to 1 micrometer, and when thickness will be very small, the fine layer of FES get formed, and this will be much more protective, and this is the ideal condition which we need to employ in our system to avoid corrosion by iron sulfide. Okay, now the last thing, if in my system there is both CO2 and H2S sorry, so which region will act as a sweet region, which act as a sour region, and which act as a mixed region, depends on the partial pressure. So if we need to find out whether in my system which corrosion, or either sweet corrosion will predominate or sour corrosion will predominate, or in my system this will be mixture of sweet and sour corrosion, so that's can be classified by this plot. This plot is referenced from the NES 202 and paper 02235. So you can look at this NES publication. Okay, so if I am in this region, then I am in sweet regime, sweet CO2 regime. So this region is sweet CO2, corrosion in this region will occur in partial pressure of H2S and CO2 get plot. And if I am in this region, here sour corrosion will occur. Okay, so this region is sour corrosion, where here see the partial pressure of CO2 to partial pressure of H2S is equal to 20. Okay, when partial pressure of CO2 to H2S is 500, then we are in here region. If partial pressure of CO2 to H2S is between 200 to 500, then we get this region. Okay, so if my system is CO2 system and it having small H2S, then it will protect our system, but when the H2S get increased, it will further aggravate the corrosion. So for concentration of H2S less than 500 ppm in gas phase, and for pH less than 5, there is no precipitation of carbonate or iron sulfide film. The data strongly suggests that the presence of even small amount of H2S will lead to rapid and significant reduction in CO2 corrosion rate. Means if my system is CO2 system and there is a small amount of H2S present in my system, so it will drastically reduce the corrosion rate of CO2, and my corrosion rate will be drastically reduced. So this is the ideal condition which we need to look for. Okay, so hope you have find this video useful, and now you will be able to differentiate between the sweet corrosion and sour corrosion, CO2 and H2S corrosion. You have understood now the partial pressure differences and what will be the effect of that partial pressure, how the protective film get formed and what is their significance. So if you find my this video useful, please subscribe my channel, share with your friends. Thank you all. And one more thing, this is a lecture series on the corrosion, and this series will get continued. So stay tuned. Thank you very much.